the Zika virus is a virus that's been around for years, but just recently it's gained a lot of attention because of a lot of infections in Brazil. And the main concern that we've had is that if infection occurs during pregnancy, this can result in bad fetal outcomes. So it can result in miscarriages, or it can result in microcephaly, the children being born with very small heads. And you can imagine that having a small head can also lead to a small brain, and so that can affect a child's development and intellectual outcomes. One out of five people who's affected by it and actually has symptoms will have fever, rash, joint pains, muscle aches, and sometimes some eye discharge. And that's the same whether people are pregnant or not pregnant. The symptoms during infection are the same. Zika virus transmission has been occurring for years in Africa, in Asia, and some Pacific islands, but what's changed is that over the past year or so, there's been a lot of transmission that's been occurring in the Americas, in the Western Hemisphere. It seems to be spreading, so we would not be surprised to see it spreading even further, and in fact, it might be starting to spread in the U.S., where the mosquito vector is. This is a different mosquito that's more in the tropics, and this mosquito bites all day long. So we probably won't have much sustained transmission. I don't anticipate that in California. I think the major concern is going to be the Gulf Coast. One should be concerned about traveling to areas where there's active transmission if you're pregnant or if you're thinking about trying to become pregnant. So if somebody is pregnant or became pregnant while traveling to one of these areas and had mosquito bites, there's concern that they could have become infected, and then there's concern that then their fetus might be affected. So they should consult their doctor. Avoiding mosquito bites is good by wearing long pants, long sleeve shirts, and then using approved mosquito repellents. And this would be using DEET, Picardin, and then oil of lemon eucalyptus is something that other people like because it's a little more natural. It's a dynamic situation, so we're talking about this today and what the situation is today, but we expect the situation to continue to evolve, and there can be continuing transmission, new areas that might become endemic for this virus, and so there might be other areas of concern. And again, we may start seeing transmission in the U.S., and so people should continue to monitor, get information from reliable sources such as the CDC and the California Department of Public Health.